testing testing 1 2 3 1 2 3 testing testing ABC ABC 1 2 3，系有冇唔清楚？又唔清楚，要即系出声，因为将会开始。
可唔可以试一次用用麦？
好。testing testing 1 2 3 1 2 3 ABC testing testing。OK。
唔该晒。
好多謝各位記者今日出席我哋文章記者會，我哋今日嘅主題係香港人唔收貨，立即調查重組。首先，我哋今日會有我哋嘅中英文發言人，跟住之後會係我哋嘅問答環節。首先，我哋再一次感謝基進報道我哋提供手語傳譯員。咁麻煩記者朋友陣間影我哋發言人嘅同事，希望都可以影到手語傳譯啦。Thank you very much for attending the season press conference today. A very warm welcome from us here. Our theme today is only a reform would do. Give us back the independence in the Independent Police Complaints Council. First, we'll come with our Chinese and English speaker, and then we'll conclude with a Q&A section. We would like to thank Radio Hong Kong yet again for lighting up sign language interpreters for oppressors. We're grateful always to have them with us every time indeed. 咁今日亦都係我哋反送中運動嘅第一位義士羅定健先生嘅逝世嘅日子嘅十一個月。咁我哋有請我哋各位在場都默默哀悼先，兩位病人站立。首先會是我們的中文發言發言，好嗎？
眾所周知，監警會是無用之物，他一陣間公布的所謂研究報告也一樣。這份報告不單沒有獨立性，更加是監警會僭越其法定機能所產生的怪物，社會絕對不能夠視之為一次有效的調查。他既然承認721對元朗站市民的無差別恐怖襲擊存在警黑勾結，亦都刻意忽略831警方無理封鎖太子站下的種種疑團。由此可見，監警報告根本絕不可信，只是政權自說自話，用來淡化警暴的劣絕把戲。人民一早清晰堅定指出，我們要的是五大訴求，我們要的是真正的獨立調查委員會，借此調查警方濫權濫暴的事實，而不是幾百頁扮作中立的廢話。根據監警會條例，其職能範圍只是限於監察、觀察和覆檢警務處處長就需要匯報投訴的處理和調查工作，並沒有法定調查權。這隻無牙老虎就連五個國際專家也因為獨立調查權不足，在去年12月主動請辭，指出需要有真正的獨立機關調查，而真正的獨立調查委員會也必須根據香港法律第86章成立。委員會的主席一般是由大法官擔任，擁有傳召證人的權力，而為了令到調查細節更加全面，立論更加公允，調查裡面的資料絕對不能夠在日後的官司成為起訴任何人的證據。自97年以來，港共政府亦都曾經五次引用這個條例成立委員會，調查對象包括近期的沙中線問題以及2012年的南丫島撞船事故等等。由此可見，我們一直爭取的獨立調查委員會絕對不是監警會或者林鄭月娥另一個東施效顰的檢討委員會可以比擬。關於獨立調查委員會的調查範圍，民間記者會在此建議針對三大問題。第一，港共內部政策決策的正當性，包括林鄭班子強推逃犯條例，經歷6月9、612態度依然強硬的原因，以及後繼暫緩或者壽終正寢等等支吾以對的狀態，和企圖利用警隊武力去解決政治問題等等的決策手段。第二，警隊制度腐化問題，包括但不限於612、721、831、101等 大型街頭運動的時候，警方有系統地無視守則等的行為，例如執法期間蒙面、移除編號等的做法。隨著政府態度更加強硬的時候，警察無理拘捕以及使用武力的情況亦都升級，不單止無視警例，更加存在誠信和人格的問題，甚至踐踏基本人權。這個是否意味著包庇同袍和縱容同袍犯法已經成為警隊內部制度不可分割的一部分呢？再者，在721元朗、8月5日北角及荃灣襲擊等為數不少的事情當中，無論是拘捕率、起訴率抑或是個控罪程度，亦都反映了執法部門是蓄意包庇襲擊示威者甚至無辜市民的黑社會人士。另外，因為警隊濫發催淚彈而導致的公共健康問題，以及在示威期間出現了大量無可疑的離奇自殺案件等的問題，亦都需要向公眾一一解答。第三點是中港關係和一國兩制的問題，當中包括中共對港共政府的干預程度，例如不同部門多次 用顏色革命、外國勢力等的口吻直接干預港共政府如何執法，以及嘗試以行政手段僭越本港的法制，例如在內地的關口針對香港人以及香港公民，例如鄭文傑被嫖妓等的事情。接下來最重要的是調查委員會所得的結果亦都必須轉化為推動社會創傷復原的政策方針，政權視警隊為維穩工具、鎮壓工具，令到警民對立、仇恨加重。但事到如今，我們除了一份報告是絕對不足夠的，只有解散和重組警隊才是真正有機會平息民憤。建議政府可以參考北愛爾蘭的彭定康報告以及格魯吉亞的重組警隊路線，政府必須重組警隊架構，削減警隊規模，例如解散為了應付佔中而成立的特別戰術小隊，刪減防暴警察人數，逐步解散現役警務人員，重新招募人才，並加入符合現代人權知識的訓練和考核內容。這個方法或者是可以解決警民仇恨之結的第一步。在這個禮拜，政權繼續命令執法機關以公共衛生及安全之名濫發限聚令告票，鄧炳強更加無視司法公正，主動公開指控懷疑遭黑警性侵的受害人作下假口供，警暴造成的人權問題只會有增無減。而今天的下午將會有一位在不公義制度下反抗的手足因為暴動惡法而被判下刑期。在香港因為警暴造成的人權寒冬之中，監警會的報告竟然將721警黑勾結的恐襲總結為警隊公關技巧問題，更加嘗試在疑團未解的時候為831蓋棺定論，這個是對我們香港人以及人權的最大侮辱。當監警會連最基本的調查權都欠奉的時候，他嘗試強行利用這份毫無公信力的報告為港共黑警種種的失誤遮醜，只會令到我們人民越發不滿，國際政府對香港的信任再進一步下降。在自由的世界絕對是不會姑息政權和港共政權，人民已經準備好下一階段的抗爭，直到我們五大訴求得以落實，公義得以彰顯為止。
The IPCC is a joke. The report it generated not only lacks independence, but is entirely toothless. This report must not be taken with any credibility. It has evaded all the key issues, including the questions on the multi-day shutdown of Prince Edward Station post 31st August terrorist attack. We did not ask for a pretentiously neutral multi-100-page document that does not address fundamental issues. The people have spoken loud and clear for almost a year for an independent investigation on the Hong Kong police force. This has not been delivered. The Independent Police Complaints Council Ordinance specifies that the functions of the IPCC are confined to merely observing, monitoring and reviewing the handling and investigation of reportable complaints by the police commissioner based on the information submitted by the police themselves. All IPCC members are appointed by the chief executive. They have no statutory investigative power to gather evidence or call witnesses. The international expert panels hired by Carrie Lam herself even threw in the towel and left in December after the government ignored their advice on a need to substantially enhance the capabilities of the IPCC. The last bit of credits the IPCC retained left along with the foreign experts then. Nothing produced by the IPCC should be taken any seriously henceforth. Rome is not built in one day. Even if an independent commission of inquiry is established under the related ordinance, it will still serve as the first baby step for Hong Konger to achieve justice. In relation to the elimination of police brutality, the Citizen Press Conference is proposing three main issues to be addressed in this commission of inquiry. Furthermore, any conclusion yielded by this report should also be able to transform into concrete policies and reforms. The first issue is the legitimacy of the dictatorial decisions made by the Hong Kong CCP regime. This includes Carrie Lam's forceful amendment of the extradition bill, the crackdowns on the 9th June, 12th June, her too late, too little suspension of the proposal, or as she puts it, putting it to sleep, which would not have legally retracted the bill, and exploitation of the Hong Kong police force to solve political problems through violence. The second issue is to be addressed instead the Hong Kong police force has now rendered Hong Kong a police state, and that it has been systematically unprincipled. Not only did they disregard their own codes of conduct, they also demonstrated personal psychological issues, making them all the more dangerous, even at the individual level. The Hong Kong police force has deliberately covered up the atrocities that range from police brutality incidents to disappearances or hastily closed suicide cases classified with no probable cause of crime. The excessive use of tear gas has caused a public health problem for the entire city, and now they have decided to use the prohibition on group gathering regulation to barge into malls and indiscriminately fine citizens. The HKPF is by every means a public hazard. The third issue that must be addressed is the broken one country, two systems framework. The CCP has consistently instructed the Hong Kong government to adapt its discourse, as demonstrable in its repeated use of terms such as color revolutions and the presence of foreign forces, and intervened directly in the separation of powers in Hong Kong. Is it still possible to seek any form of justice from within the heavily ordered system, especially when Hong Kong citizens could be arbitrarily detained by mainland police at ports? Or even, would pursuing two countries, two systems now be the only way to free Hong Kong from its predicament? It seems the case now that Hong Kong must look beyond our system, which is practically a fraud, for justice. Human rights concerned groups such as the Sounds of Silenced and the Civil Rights Observer has been submitting reports to the United Nations on allegations of torture, civil and political rights abuses, and disability discrimination. The all-party parliamentary group in the UK has also taken the initiative to inquire into human rights and humanitarian principles violations by the Hong Kong police force, which have received almost 1,000 submissions as of now. This would serve as exemplar of any international commitment and effort to achieve and contemplate with rigor and impartiality the onslaughts on human rights in Hong Kong, and communicate strong and compelling messages to international leaders with watertight, expertly done accounts. On top of that, the Northern Ireland Police Reform Report commissioned by Chris Patton can serve as a practical reference for the case of Hong Kong. In short, a true and unbiased comprehensive investigation, as the whole world understands it, can only be done by credible third-party committees that respect fundamental human and political rights. The only way to respond to the IPCC's report, and perhaps its entire existence, is to ignore it, for it is frankly dead. The people do not trust it. The international community does not trust it either. As the regime continues to crack down on Hong Kongers with their repressive state apparatus, as this repressive state apparatus is itself an outlaw, as it habitually criminalizes victims into suspects, as this report dares to put down the police triad collusion on the 21st of July as a public relation mistake. The fact that the terroristic Hong Kong police force exists is a violation on humanitarian principles in itself. The free world will not just watch on, because they know that Hong Kongers are fighting for being human, and that we deserve more better than being bulldozed by a criminal regime. We will stay on the streets until we see justice done, truly done. Thank you.
咁喺度想補充一句嘅，喺今日下晝將會公布監警會呢份報告嘅時候，同一日 較早前梁君彥主席佢係直接係宣布將陳建波係命令佢成為呢個內會主席去處理呢個選舉事務，我哋喺度表示係極度憤怒，都係唔可以接受嘅。你點可以係咁樣去完全繞過咗成個內會嘅規定去做呢個決策？你此例一開，日後嘅後患必然無窮。而呢個國歌法都好快會喺大會度進行呢個議讀。咁我哋希望市民係有心理準備，係去出翻承受當我哋希望市民係有心理準備，係去同呢個政府呢個極權決一死戰。
As of now, the chairman of the Legislative Council, Mr. Leung, has appointed another member, Mr. Chen, as to be the chairman of the Internal Affairs Committee, which this action totally ignores the legal proceeding of the Legislative Council, which further reduces the letdown of Hong Kong to be a rubber stamp. This is exactly the action which triggers the Hong Kong people. This ruins, this violates our rule of law, and this is not acceptable. And if the regime decides to do this, to ignore, to bypass the law, and they will have repercussion from the people.
We'll now proceed to the Q&A section of the day. Due to the limitation of the time, we would like to ask each journalist to pose no more than 2 questions at a time. And also please identify your affiliation, which media organization you work for. What is your term? Thank you very much.
首先好多謝蘋果記者嘅提問啦。咁首先就問到點解我哋會搶先喺份報告出嚟之前就做個表態先嘅？咁喺度我哋係想同廣大市民甚至政府講翻我哋嘅定調係，我哋絕對唔會承認呢一份嘅報告嘅。因為如果我哋喺之後回應嘅話，就只會係令到大家係針對份報告嘅內容繼續去討論入面嘅用詞啦，或者係入面嘅時序正唔正確。但係我哋要嘅係乜嘢啊？我哋唔係一份咁樣嘅報告，我哋要嘅係獨立調查委員會，係一個真正符合我哋五大訴求嘅內容。我哋希望搶先喺呢一個報告出爐之前啦，同大家去講清楚我哋對政府嘅把關係乜嘢，亦都希望市民即使喺下晝要去討論呢份報告嘅時候，無忘我哋抗爭嘅初心，無忘我哋對五大訴求嘅堅持。咁而第二係關於問到721嗰、那個警方佢係否定咗呢個係警黑勾結嘅一個提問嘅時候，我哋民間記者會係認為啦，咁就首先我哋因為個詳細內容未出，我哋唔知道佢到底根據啲乜嘢去否定呢一個嘅警黑勾結啦。第二，亦都係完全充分表現到呢一個監警會缺乏一個獨立嘅調查權力，佢冇權傳召任何嘅證人或者係目擊者係去為呢一個721嘅元朗事件係作出任何嘅補充。其實你見到無論係港台嘅新聞，又或者早前嘅片段，都係明顯見到有警務人員啦同白衣人係搭曬膊頭嘅喎。咁點解佢可以無視種種嘅片段呢？充分係反映到呢一份嘅監檢報告，除咗不公允之餘，亦都係缺乏任何嘅調查能力嘅。
跟住有邊位記者想？
想問翻，即係民間記者會喺呢方面係有乜？
繼續。
回應翻記者的提問啦，啱啱？喂！啱啱講緊嘅就係佢呢一份報告係針對一啲大場面，我哋好難去咁究竟有啲咩問題，我哋想了解到嘅就係呢份報告，正如我哋啱啱嘅稿入邊都提到嘅，就係話佢係欠缺咗一個基本嘅調查權力。首先，監警會是沒有權去調查社會事件，他調查的只能夠是警務處內部就警員作出的投訴去複核、去觀察、去調查，但他是不能夠僭越去調查社會事件的。既然他沒有這個法定職能，亦意味著他沒有這個法定權力去調查，當一個沒有法定權力去調查的社的組織去調查的時候，他就一定會欠缺，正如是他沒有權力去傳召證人，傳召了 的人員是可以不出現，是可以不作供，而且他搜集到的資料日後是可以在法庭上作為檢控不同人士的證據。在這些條件之下，我們很難見到他能夠避免到一個作供的證人會不會不盡不實的這個問題。所以話呢一份報告先天上就出現咗缺陷，而其次正如佢有呢啲缺陷嘅同時，佢亦都同普通嘅市民喺睇直播或者喺街頭上嘅所見所聞係出現咗直接衝突嘅。無論係見到嘅嘢好多係冇提及到，而見到譬如話警黑勾結或者封鎖太子831封鎖太子站嘅呢啲決定是否公允？同市民的直觀感覺同市民的 common sense 是有很大的出入的時候，這個就是我們對他十分之有質疑的情況。而為什麼我們要要求去作出這個獨立調查委員會，首先就是這個是一個 baby step， 是一個香港人達至公義的第一步。我們首先要有一個有權力去調查的機構作出一個公允第三方 unbiased 的一個調查的時候，才可以再proceed 落去。而當然政權亦都會明白，林鄭月娥是沒可能不知道她有這條路可揀，沙中線是一個例子，南丫島撞船事件是一個例子，她是可以成立獨立調查委員會，引用獨立調查條例，但她選擇不敢做，要意味到林鄭月娥是選擇不敢做的前提之下，我們很難去 set 一個死線，話點樣你先會開，點樣幾時唔開，我哋就會繼續做啲乜嘢。我哋好難做到呢樣嘢，但係我哋要明白到，係佢選擇唔敢做嘅時候，香港人就會繼續抗爭，繼續以五大訴求作為初衷。
Hi, I'm from RTHK. Did you have comments on reports on the IPCC report that they do not consider the July 21st incident in Yuen to be a case of collusion between suspected triads and the police force?
The reporter has just asked us to comment on the content regarding the 21st of July in a Yuen station. To start with, as we have mentioned in our speech, that the public should totally ignore the IPCC report, as it does not contain any statutory investigative power to conduct an unbiased and comprehensive investigation. Let's to mention that it even does not have this power to conduct such investigation. And secondly, by framing the 21st of July incident as a public relation mistake, this statement or this framing is directly contradictory to the common sense of the people when they are watching live streams on YouTube or other social media, or their understanding towards the whole incident.
But regardless, we believe that this IPCC report is just another trick up Carrie Lam's sleeves to shift the focus of the Hong Kong people. And the Citizen Press Conference would like to assert once again that our ultimate goal is the five demand and not one less. Thank you.
應該怎樣參考北愛爾蘭或者是格魯吉亞的、即重組工隊方式啦。首先其實、兩大重點是我們想提出，第一就是他的警隊的權力是要、就是、放低他的權力的這樣。第二的重點就是盡量是在他新、就是、招募的人員方面是考量回是加入回一些符合我們現代化人權的一些、操練啦又或者是訓練。首先在、放下權力那裡啦，就跟北愛爾蘭的例子有點不同，因為北愛爾蘭它當初是、產生的衝突是因為宗教問題而產生的，就跟香港可能因為政見不同而產生是有點不同的時候呢，其實我們最想政府做的就是你取消一些不必要的、就是、機動部隊，你速龍小隊或者防暴隊伍。喂，其實香港真的沒有恐怖分子的，你憑什麼當我們平民是恐怖分子，我支槍對住我們的頭啊？你憑什麼用你的膝頭壓住我的頸啊？我們什麼事都沒有做過，即是我們什麼都沒有做錯的。而這個大重點就是要令到整個警隊是完全去除軍事化。你警隊警方的作用是什麼？就是你服務社會服務人民，而不是當我們是仇人，這個是第一點啦。而第二點就是在個過渡期間，我們建議就是向、格魯吉亞去參考，在過渡期間可能在新的警務人員去訓練的時候，中間是會有一個短暫的真空期，在這個時候其實是除了由其他紀律部隊去暫時組成一個警隊之餘，我們普通市民亦都應該是參與其中的，例如可以由當即我們當地的一些、地方的議員去組成一些非武裝的、即非武裝的一個監察團體或者是民間團體，是輔助當時的不同的紀律部隊去做一個巡邏啦，甚至是可以用公民逮捕方式去協助執法的。咁樣呢個係我哋即集中的兩項建議。其實我哋最核心的就是麻煩你警方去除軍事化，不要當我哋係仇人。你唯有咁樣做，你唯有你唯有咁樣做先係可以令到我哋嘅警民關係嘗試有個突破，或者係嘗試解決我哋彼此之間對立嘅情況。
仲有冇其他嘅問題
？Sorry, just very quickly. With regards to the pattern report, are you looking for the Hong Kong police to try to disband tactical units or a special tactical unit or the exact proposal that you have to reform or try to change the composition of the police force?
Thank you for the question, which is regarding our reference to the Chris Patten Northern Ireland report. I think the main goal of reforming the police is not what the opposition has claimed, that we would like anarchy or lawlessness in our city. Our main goal of reforming or even disbanding the police force is to achieve demilitarization in the police force. Because as after the umbrella movement, there are new tactics or even special units or even facilities that train the police to crack down on public events, including demonstrations, rallies, and marches. I believe these so-called preparations or training are antagonizing the relationship between the citizens and the police. The police's main goal should be securing the safety of a city instead of suppressing the voice of political reform and the quest for human rights protection. And so instead of just chanting slogans of disbanding the police force, or even, as some said, black cops have the whole family killed, we are looking for a more practical reference in the international society, including Northern Ireland example and the Georgia example. These can serve as very practical experience for a government which cares of its people to look into and to carry out as the first step to have a reconcile between the public authority and the civilian. Thank you.好明顯，檢討委員會係一個煙幕，係一種語言藝術。獨立檢討委員會點解咁翹口咧？點解成日都講錯咧？好明顯，佢就係想用一個混淆視聽嘅方式，等啲星斗市民覺得係唔知係獨立調查、獨立檢討，總之嗱能搞掂佢啦，係一種咁樣嘅狀態。但佢實質上係冇獨立檢討委員會，實質上係冇任何法理依據，佢亦都唔存在一個明確嘅職能、權力以及點樣搜證。喺 methodology 方面，獨立檢討委員會係不足，而且係唔能夠去令呢個社會進一步去愈合或者磨合。咁所以我哋會堅持有呢個獨立調查委員會，而呢個調查委員會係基於香港法例第86條《檢討委員會條例》去成立，呢一個先至係能夠令到社會愈合、長治久安嘅方式。而呢個亦都係民間記者會今日提出，又可以針對三大方面，而且呢三大方面點樣去轉化成為一個實質嘅政策改革方案？呢個係我哋今日最想達到嘅。
或者在這裡補充一句，問到其實用什麼方法，我們簡單就是說，你無論是獨立檢討委員會又好，還是你監警會報告都好，其實我們所有的方案或者可以達即是重組警隊的一個方法，我們已經給出來了民間。你政府一天你不肯開聲說要做的時候，我們就繼續抗爭，這個最簡單的。我們繼續做我們的黃色經濟圈，我們繼續做我們國際戰線，我們繼續做我們本地的街頭戰線，我們用什麼方法都好，我們一定是會去達到我們最後的目標，就是五大訴求。那就看你政府你肯不肯即是聽我們的民意，還是你仍然是一意孤行。請
問有沒有其他記者？
好，如果冇嘅，咁都多謝曬咁多記者嚟到。咁今日嘅民間記者會都到此為止，唔該曬。咁都祝各位手足身體健康，身心身體。Mm-hmm.